Yo guys, what's up? Steven back here from Soccer Boy Horse Girl YouTube channel. Today I'm going to be talking about the Mancini lineup, what makes it amazing, what makes it good, and a few thoughts that I think and what will make it bad, what will make it better in the future, and also the recent signings for Manchester City. So make sure to tune in, get comfy, let's go. So guys, anyways, so the Man City lineup will be good. Let's start with some news, as well as new players. Jeremy Doku just signed as the right wing. Before that, kind of Kyle Walker. He's the right back. He was literally kind of doing everything there. He was controlling everything, but it was too much pressure on him, as well as the injury. Kevin De Bruyne. He got hurt very bad, and then that gave the opposition, I think it was right, let me check, I think it was Bruyne, I don't know, let me check. So anyways, tomorrow they're playing against Shieldsfield. And so that would be great to see that game. And so, that was just a sad match to see Kevin De Bruyne going, because of the fact that he was injured pretty bad there, and it was just not what people expected. They didn't want a very good player going off the field. And latest news is saying that he might not be on for quite a long time. So we're going to see that. He might start doing practice and all, but for the most part, he's not going to be playing. Their last fixture was against Newcastle 1-0, which they won. Their match before that was against Burnley. That's the thing. That's when Kevin De Bruyne got hurt, he wasn't really hurt. He just felt sick, which is what I think happened. But 3-0, Burnley taking a red card, and then as well as them playing Arsenal, which was a loss, a very bad loss, 4-1 in penalties. They were tied 1-1, they went into penalties, they lost 4-1. Last season they did the same exact thing, but except for Man City won 4-1 last season, but no penalty kicks. Atletico Madrid beat them 2-1 pretty badly, as well as them winning against Bayern 2-1. And it was just amazing. Them for the UEFA last season, they won that one really well. They took a 4-0 victory. After that, they went into the FA Cup, winning 2-1 against Man United. That's already two cups, as well as the Premier League Cup. I forgot who they played. And then as well as them going to the UEFA Champions League final, and they won 1-0 against Inter Milan. And then after that, they won the Super Cup, which was 5-4 in penalty kicks, tied 1-1 in the time. And then they went into overtime, I think it was the same. And then they won the Super Cup, the UEFA Super Cup, with 5-4 in penalty kicks, which was, it was kind of hard, and no one was really expecting Sevilla to go into the finals. It was more of people thinking maybe Man City versus Real Madrid, or maybe Barcelona, because these teams are very good, but it didn't work out that way, and so it would have been a better match, honestly, if these teams were there, or Bayern there. Off Man City, just Harry Kane just signing for Bayern, leaving Tottenham Hotspurs, which is not the best idea, but there are a few rules that he has to follow, which he does not want to, but, you know, signing for a good team can bring you consequences. And then tomorrow at 8 a.m., they're playing Shieldsfield United. And this is going to be Jeremy Doku's first chance to show who he is, and that's just going to be great. If we go to the lineup here, players, if we go to the lineup, we've got Erling Haaland forward and Kevin De Bruyne, he's back. Would you look at that? And then Julian Alvarez playing forward, Bernardo Silva playing midfield, Jack Grealish playing midfield, Phil Foden as well, midfield. And I think the main goalie will be Ederson for this match. Manuel Akinji playing center back, as well as Nathan Ake with Hayo Cancelo. One of their new signings is Mateo Kovacic, the midfielder from Chelsea. Yep, Chelsea. And then Stefan Argueta, backup goalkeeper. Oscar Bob there as well. Cole Palmer was playing right wing as well. John Stones will be playing. I don't see anything showing. I don't see anything about Jeremy Doku. So he might just not be playing this match. He might be a substitute. I'm not sure. Calvin Phillips, he's showing as a substitute. Scott Carson, Sergio Gomez, as well as Rico Lewis, Josko Gvardiol, the new defender that signed not too long ago as a center back, James Mikate, a midfielder, Oscar Bob as well. Oh yeah, Jeremy Doku, now I see him right here. And so that's just going to be a great lineup. This is going to be a great match tomorrow. And if we go to the standings, I don't know, I call them standings, I don't know what, there we go. So right now, Man City's in fifth. Brighton is playing right now. I'm not sure. Right now, Tottenham Hotspurs, that's interesting. They're number one right now. Number two, West Ham, they're winning right now 1-0. Arsenal in third, no match going on right now. Brighton 0-1. And they're losing right now. In fourth place, Man City. In fifth, Man United right after. Brentford after that. And Liverpool, they're not really doing well. In last, we've got Everton, as well as Burnley and Luton Town. And they're in the position of being knocked out of the Premier League. So this is just going to be kind of sad seeing them go. Let's go to the latest news here. Alright, so De Bruyne, Man City star Kevin De Bruyne in this, what? Oh, okay, so he just came back. Chelsea's latest is Man City bid, they're trying to get a player against Wolves and Liverpool, from Wolves. And Liverpool and Man City are bidding right now. Report, Man City consider moving for Premier League star linked with Spurs. So Spurs and Man City might be moving up. We're not sure right now. More news here. Jeremy Doku for $65 million. That's not that much, but I think he might be happy. He's a very creative player. He's a right wing. He's going to be amazing. Signing for number 11 here. I think this is just going to be a great season with their new signings. Trying to get more new signings. I think it's just going to be a great season. So thank you guys for watching this video. Make sure to like and subscribe. See you guys next video. Bye.